Hello, 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 everyone. Welcome back to Let's Play Tales of Berseria. We are back. There's actually a plant over here, signs point to no. We are at Palamedes Temple. I don't know how far into this thing we have to get in order to be a liberator. I also can't investigate more than here. Things like these guys are a lot slower than I am, so it should really make... Oh, I remember this place now. Very cool dungeon, actually. I'm hoping that it's completely solved already. It will just let me run to the end. So I do remember that, like, making my way through here was a pain the first time, but I'm pretty sure... Oh, well, there you are. Okay, well, that was... that was easy. Now that's interesting.
Not worth my time.
It actually ran away, so it's weak. It's a amorphous fiend that is weak to earth. So amorphous.
It's the demon eating demon.
The more it eats, the more ferocious it gets, right?
I'd rather not find out. Let's take it down fast.
Interesting. That was a super cool fight. I enjoyed that. The whole, like, you have to sort of control the field. Now, granted, I think if I had been roughly at the same level, it would have been a lot more difficult.
Whew. I don't know how, but we managed to beat it.
I know how.
It devoured other demons purely by instinct. Sounds kind of like me, doesn't it?
I mean, we all thought that, yeah.
Few cows, or demons, whatever. When you're hungry, you eat. The only ones who put any moral weight on it are humans. Personally, I wouldn't sweat it too much.
What are you trying to say?
It's
don't be like a human.
I don't really care if I'm seen as a
you are the Lord of Calamity.
I don't really know how to put it, but... I sensed a kind of strength inside that demon. Like a determination to continue living. It was powerful and frightening, but I don't think it was bad.
Aww.
Figures.
Okay, well that was a much... I both am glad and am not glad I didn't come here earlier, because yeah, like, I was so much stronger than it was that I just kind of like ran over it, which is cool. But also a little disappointing. Because I didn't necessarily want to run over it, you know? I wanted an actual fight, and I didn't really get one. Like, it was able to fully heal, and I was like, okay, I'll just get souls off of killing these little guys, and then just go all out. And I went all out, and it went all flat. Hey, we solved that. another quest bites the dust. Now we need to go to... It looks like Stoneberry actually has two different things. Then we'll get Roku's quest. Because I was trying to, like, save Mogilu's stuff, but it turns out that Mogilu's stuff is on the way to a lot of this other stuff. So, the Stoneburrow... Or Stonebury is the, Norman dolls. Not interested, sir. You keep your squawk squawk to yourself. Uh-huh. You suck. I actually wasn't sure that that would work, and I also didn't think I cared. Like, I was like, if I have to fight them, I'll just blaze through them. I just kind of like that the demon wanted to keep living, and that's kind of why it ran away from me at first. It was like, oh crap, not you. I can sense that you're way bigger than I am. Ow! Ow! Stop! Back here so I can kill you. I wonder, it is interesting when you think about it. Now, I don't know what abruptly made me think of this, but Zavid's been around all this time, like, tangled with the Lord of Calamity, and then was still, like, ran into Saray and, you know, had to struggle against him, and I feel like Velvet is a lot stronger than Saray is. Especially at this point, but even back at, you know, the first meeting with Zavid for each of their storylines, I feel like Velvet would have been stronger. By a lot. I think it was just that Aizen was like, man, you are so strong, and yeah, no one. So Ray was only like that to other humans. I just have to wonder what these guys must be thinking. They see me come by and just be like, eh. Well, I was supposed to run over him. And that was the plan for that voice line. But it didn't happen. Try that again. And they see me just go like, eh. And yet they still attack. I mean, you can argue that that's just their demonic nature, where they, most of them know nothing but the fight. And if I saw someone do that to a person I knew, I'd be like, I'm just gonna stay out of their way. This seems dangerous. Oh, no, up. Nothing in here, right? I think I've already been in here. I have not. I'm glad I checked. No, I'm talking to the one with the... Well, looks like Leone.
Hey, have you heard the rumors? People are saying there's a talking Pengyon around.
I didn't know Pengyons could talk.
It's true. Three people have already talked with it near the beach at night.
You don't say. We should totally try to capture it. It'd be a great addition to Moggy Lou's menagerie.
Let's find another side quest.
Well, this is no light matter here in Isolde. Local legend has it that when the end times come, a talking Pengie will declare judgment upon the sinful. Everyone who's encountered this Pengie has been bedridden from the sheer shock of it.
Are you sure it's not just some demon?
It doesn't appear to be, though it does seem to be quite aggressive.
Interesting.
It goes after people, attacking them as it yells, "I'm a medical student from Rize
Maxia." Wait, what the?
Is that supposed to be its judgment or whatever?
I have no idea, but whatever you do, you'd better not visit the
beach.
Why
is Jude over here causing a problem?
Reverse psychology trick, right?
Ugh, I can't sleep. I think
yeah,
I'm
going
to head down to the beach and check things out.
I'm with you. Some things just can't be avoided.
You're going to look for that talking Pengie, aren't you?
What makes you say that? We're just going on a walk.
Okay, I'm bringing everyone. I'm like, it's not just me, is it? Like, not that I would be afraid of Jude with Velvet, but I'm a little afraid of the Jude that, like, this game would throw at me, if that makes sense. If they play as badly as I played Jude, we're fine. But granted, they do have that, like, reversal move that Jude has, that would be a pain.
Look, Velvet! There's a Pengie!
Think it might be the talking one?
You don't look like Jude.
Oh, good evening. Lovely weather, isn't it?
It really talked!
I can't believe it. Something I eat can talk?
Huh? Wait, do you guys eat us Pengie's too?
Why does it matter?
Please, answer my question. It's very important.
I'm sorry, but yes, I eat them.
And I'll happily devour most anything if I have to.
I mean, that does make sense for Velvet.
Well then, I suppose you people are just like the others who came before. I can't let you keep doing that.
Oh, and what's a cutesy little Pengie like you plan on doing about us, big bad humans?
Yep. I am so confused. Level 81. Weak to fire. I may not be able to beat this.
I'm sorry for deceiving you all, but I can't let you hurt any more Pengie's.
Ready to die? Think you can dodge?
Hey, buddy. I also use fists.
Ruin smash! Ruin smash!
Okay, I need to change my arts out slightly. I need a pure fire. Oh, here we go. Alright, give it on him. This is such a weird, random bit of fan service they put in here. I'm not waiting for it. I almost had a perfect fight on him, but not quite. Oh. And he's very movable. Sorry, Jude.
Turn back into a Pengion. No matter.
Wait, why are you so intent on fighting us when you're outnumbered?
Please don't say that.
I have to protect my fellow Pengions from the likes of poachers like you.
Poachers?
We're not poachers, I swear. We just came here to see a talking Pengion.
Really? But then, why did you guys say you eat Pengions?
Sorry, I guess we should have explained more clearly. This one will eat anything.
Yeah, sorry about that.
And as for me, the only pengyon I ever eat is what I buy properly at the market.
I mean, that doesn't really matter to the pengyon now, does it?
We're not good people, but we're not those kinds of villains either.
Oh, well, in that case, I should apologize for jumping to conclusions and picking a fight. I just ran into some Pengion poachers earlier, and I'm afraid I'm a little on edge right now.
Those such a must bizarre be the side quest. Have spotted you here. They're all sick in bed just from the shock of meeting you. Small fries like them, I bet they'll think twice before they try to poach another animal.
So, what are you then? Some special representative of Pengion kind?
No, I'm Jude Mathis. I'm a medical student from Riza Maxia.
What?
A medical student? From Riza Maxia?
It's in a different world from yours. Actually, I'm a human just like you all, but... Somehow I was flung into this dimension, and when I came to, I looked like this.
So, basically, you're a human from another world, but when you came here, it made you turn into a Pengion?
This story of yours, quite a tale. The whole thing's pretty hard to...
I mean, it's easier since we actually fought him.
However, when I was lost and confused, the Pengions here were kind to me, and took me in as their own. I wanted to repay the favor to them since they've done so much for me.
So you've been protecting them from any poachers who come.
But don't you have bigger things to worry about right now? Looks to me like you're too soft-hearted.
I get that a lot.
Well, we've heard your story. But even if it is true, it doesn't sound like there's anything we can do for you.
Yeah, there really kind of isn't.
Don't worry about me. I'll figure out how to get home on my own, one way or another. The problem is that a friend of mine got sent to this world with me, but I haven't been able to find her. My hunch is that she's also turned into a Pengion. You haven't heard of any other talking Pengions, have you?
Can't say I have.
Sorry. I swear to God, if it's Mila.
Okay.
What kind of person is this friend of yours? Maybe we'll run into her later.
Her name is Mila. She has pretty red eyes and long golden hair.
Oh my gosh, she has right, Mila too.
Dignity and possesses a commanding presence. What else? Oh, and one of her quirks is that whenever she sees something tasty, she drools.
That's an interesting quirk.
You mean she actually drools?
Also, she's known as the Lord of Spirits, because she's accompanied by four summon spirits with command over the elements.
I just woke them up.
Ooh, Lord of Spirits. How royal sounding.
Got it. If we hear anything, we'll let you know.
It may be hard, but try to keep your spirits up, Jude.
This is such a bizarre side event.
I hope you guys get a lead on Mila.
I bet we possibly will if I run around.
Well, how do I put it? She's just a really special person to me, I guess.
Fair enough.
I mean, that is something that Velva would at least understand.
Talking Pengion. I didn't dream that up, right?
No, that Pengion was very real. Or rather, it seems to actually be a human named Jude.
Yeah, there's Mila around somewhere.
He said he came from another world. No matter how much we see, life is still full of mysteries, isn't it?
He's got guts, I'll give him that. It'd be nice if we could help him somehow.
What?
He's kind to Pengions, too.
If he was telling the truth, that would make him a castaway from another dimension.
Okay, that at least makes a degree for Aizen. I'm like, why? He doesn't want to help them.
Personally, I'm curious about this Mila girl, the Lord of Spirits. She might have a connection to the Four Empyreans, or even Enominat himself.
Seems unlikely, but I suppose anything's possible. Just in case, I'll keep everything Jude the Pengion told us in mind.
So that happened. I wonder if at a random inn somewhere else we're going to run into the Mila quest. It seems likely. I'm really glad I stopped in there, even though it confused me a lot. Like, I'm still not 100% sure what to make of it. But it was still definitely not something I was expecting to run across, and it ended up being a lot of fun. It also wasn't a lot of times like the EX dungeons, and I know in Zesteria you could run into, I think it was Jade, not Jude. And that was just epic pants on head difficult. Like, that's kind of what I was worried I was somehow running into right here by accident. But I was willing to give a shot, and a shot I gave. Okay. So next we will go back to here to Renied. I know I said I was going to go and get the other town in the Norman dolls, but I realized that that's actually close to the end of the game, and there's a chance, not a good chance, mind you, but a chance that I can just go get, take care of this and come back this way, whereas I'm definitely going to have to go to the Vexen multiple times. Like, once I get all the dolls, I'm sure that will unlock something. I'm also definitely going to have to go out of my way to, check all the inns for Mila. Not in here, though. I have a suspicion it will be in an inn. It is just a suspicion, but... Well, you're rude.
Come on,
yeah, I was
really?
Like, this is not an area you guys should be challenging me in. I tell you what. Leave me alone! My god! We really don't need to use that on these guys, I promise.
Come on, really?
I agree. I'm definitely making a priority to get this, moving thing. Because there's no reason not to, and it'll let me just run through here very quickly. You can kind of tell which areas I explored before that little thing unlocked, because I made a point to always get it. Whenever I would see it, except for that one area where I passed it twice, because I'm super smart. I definitely did not prioritize it here. Thankfully, I think I can get there without having to fight anything else. Because, yeah, based on the way these fights are going, I can definitely just run over these fools. Oh my gosh, it was only for that one screen? Come on. Just to make sure, because we are going to Vortigern. Okay. There's the other one. You're just a game merchant. A game merchant! You definitely want to pick this up. Okay, there's nothing. I thought there might be people piled up right there, and I'm like, well, I'll just kill them. I'll pick that up. I don't make it a priority because, like, in these areas, it's never anything super relevant. Just tried to kill myself. That's okay. I'm allowed. Get out of here. Get out of here. Alright, so the question is how far through Vortigern are we going to have to get in order to encounter this thing? where I started. This thing won't tell me where it is. I mean, it might... Okay, it's definitely above us. I need to go this way. Oh my, get out of here.
It's over.
Oh, it's very over. That's right, you have to do this to get across. Grumble, grumble, grumble. I mean, I guess I can't complain. It's not difficult, and I'm getting a lot of souls from it. Although, this is one of those things I should have written down where all the souls I couldn't pick up are, because I've got 600 of them now. Isn't this supposed to be where he is? He's on the eastern roof. Gosh darn it.
We can do this.
I mean, at least this is nothing.
Just how does this sword work?
Don't touch it. You'll hurt yourself.
In other words, the rest of her is fair game.
Not unless you really want to get hurt.
It's been forever since I saw that. I forgot that was an interaction. Ooh, it's a dangerous encounter. That was a very dangerous encounter, guys. We are lucky we survived. Is this not... Can I get back this way? Please let me get back. I promise I don't want to run around. Oh, darn it to... Boy, guys, like we're at 30 minutes. I could stop here, but it just feels really lame to stop here. That would be lame. Okay, so let's just get through here right quick. Just went the wrong way, not a big deal. That's the western roof. I don't see any way to get to the eastern roof. But I have to assume going east would do it. Alright, is this the roof? Not yet. is this. This is probably the roof, though. Alright, we made it.
I see you've come, Shigure.
Count Capulus. It's been a long time.
Oh, wait. Is that you, Rokuro? Leave now. You are not the one who I summoned here. I want your brother, the traitor Shigure.
Sir, if I'm not mistaken, I believe Shigure's execution was assigned to me.
Ha! Oh, please. Don't make me laugh. You had your chance. You couldn't even scratch him, you wretched dog. Frankly, I don't need any Rangetsu to do my bidding any longer. Not with the power that I've attained by devouring everyone in the entire manor. I shall administer your punishments myself, with my own
hand. I figured it'd be a fight.
You're the one who devoured the people at the manor? How could you do that?
I never knew humans were so delicious. After I make a meal of you and the rest of those damnable exorcists, this will be my kingdom, my feeding ground.
Welp, it looks like the only thing that got abducted was this guy's conscience.
Remain there, Rokuro. Your lord commands you. Wait and be thankful that your blood will stain my blade beside your brother's.
There's no reasoning with this guy.
Wait.
Rokuro?
I refuse. If you simply wanted to eat flesh, then perhaps I wouldn't stop you. But dying to you would make a mockery of the Rangetsu name. Turn your blade on me or my brother and we won't hold back. Not even against an impotent lord.
You! How dare you speak to your master?
Oh, so this is possibly not after we've already dealt with Shigure. So level 73, weak to water, armored, undead, and feed. So, Heaven's Wrath. Binding Frost, Fiend. Best not Thrust, and then just a... Actually, let's end with Heaven's Wrath. Which is weird that she has Heaven's Wrath as a move, and then we'll start with just a very fast water attack.
This cur has fangs, he's all too happy to use.
Oh, wow. Okay, I was thinking that maybe this would be easier because it wasn't expecting me to have already gotten Rangoro. Or Shigure. There is a... I'm just afraid I'm losing it. That's important. Ow. All right, we're making headway. It's slow going, but it's happening. All right, here we go. Dang it! It's so hard to keep this, although he's up to 4 now, so maybe it'll be easier. I need to wait for the paralysis to go off. Damn it! I finally got up to 4 and then I let him hit me. Whoa, I did not think that would hit me. Buddy. Avengers to me, I'm the one attacking you. I say that like everyone else isn't attacking him. I got a little panicky when I heard not good. I thought actually he had killed Aizen, but he did not.
Blade of Heaven's will pierce my enemies! It's
darkness! Oh, dang. I thought I avoided that. I obviously did not.
Fire!
Oh, I totally dodged that. Yeah, I got caught in the animation. Sometimes the animation saves me, oftentimes it doesn't. Dang it! Oh my gosh! Like, I granted, a lot of this is me not thinking about, like, being a little bit too noobish in terms of how I'm playing it. Back on your feet, I'm not done with you yet.
No, I can't die here.
I thought I dodged that. I had every intention of dodging that. Alright. He's almost dead. I'm gonna go ahead and use the life bottle. I don't wanna miss the experience. There we go.
I thought we were done for.
I mean, that was a very, very, fight.
I'm sorry. I know you were hoping to negotiate an alliance.
Don't worry. I don't think he's someone we could fight alongside.
I mean, he wasn't even rational.
Come on, Rokuro. You wanted to kill him from the very start, didn't you?
No. Well, maybe a little.
So you did want to.
A little.
You're a pretty scary guy when push comes to shove. Whatever happened to honoring your ancestral debt?
I don't think I'm a hypocrite. My debt was made when I was human. That has nothing to do with the demon I am now.
That's how you really look at it?
I do. I incurred my debt toward you after I became a demon, and you can count on me to repay it.
I'll take your word for it then.
But Rokuro, when the Count said he was going to kill Lord Shigure, was that really something impossible to forgive?
How do I say it? I will kill anyone who disparages Arangetsu's skill. That's all. That's just nonsense. I'm sure I sound like the Count. I won't ask you to understand.
Of course I don't understand. But still, I don't think it's nonsense. There are just some things a person can't surrender.
All right. And with that, we will at last be ending this episode. This episode kind of went on forever, but you know what? I think it was a good one. And considering the snafu that ended up costing us one of the episodes this week, I think it's fair. I think it's fine. I'm okay with it. Alright, and with that done, see you next time, guys. Most likely in the last village, because I don't think we have. You've only got those two that are obvious. I do still want to try and find Mila. So we'll see if we can do that as well. See you then.